the Instagram clips for outdoors were ripping on a stock bike and a pretty short track. How is it to go back home and just rip around and get back into the flow of things?
It's nice. It's a breath of fresh air. It's more like just clearing my mind and having fun riding, like not worrying about anything, just getting motos in. Like I wanted to work on my fitness earlier on for outdoors, and I kind of got a bit of a road closure there with my back. I couldn't really work through that very easy, so I was just having a blast, man, just doing 40s like I was going to run out of them. And it was nice because there's nobody out there, just me and, you know, Josh giving me the occasional, like, you know, halfway or something, you know what I mean? Like, pretty primitive stuff we always did, so I just had fun, man. It's really nice up there.
Stock bike.
Yeah.
Just go out and just do laps and get back into it?
Dude, yeah, it was tough to ride that thing, like, the whole time. It's like, you know, it's not my setting. It just did so soft, and I'm like, I'm trying to push and, like, get the workout, and I think it made it harder on me because, like, the setting was so off. So I was just having a hard time, like, you know, sticking the corners. I had to fight, like, the whole time, you know. So, but I just took everything that was going on up there and just for the good, and tried to spin it as a, you know, like, almost like a vacation where I get to ride, you know.
So the back injury thing, I mean, that's been one of the many issues this year.
Yeah.
How do you feel now after a little bit of a break, a little bit of time to recover, everything like that?
I feel actually pretty good after Denver. I took like 4 days or so and didn't really do a whole lot of anything, and that helped a lot. So I've actually been feeling pretty good since then. Just, it's tough in the middle of the season. You can't just, it seems like 4 days isn't a lot, doesn't mm-hmm. sound like a lot, but that's tough to get that many in the middle of a series, you know, so. You're always having to do something or go somewhere or ride somehow. So it's not like I was able to, you know, even in between Nashville when I heard it and Denver, I tried to ride one time in the middle. And, you know, so just not getting the amount of days off that you need for an injury and an ailment to heal. So after those 4 days and just chilling, it felt pretty dang good actually. And then got back on the bike, started pounding those long motos, and now I feel even better. So.
Rookie season in the 450 class, has it been what you expected or a bigger challenge or something?
Yeah, much bigger challenge than I expected, just because I think the biggest difference is how deep the field is. If you make a little mistake, you get passed by default, you know, whereas maybe in the lights or 250 class, when you make a mistake, I think you just have a little more breathing room. You know, there just isn't as many good guys. I mean, look at how many champions are out there riding, you know. So I think that's the biggest thing, is just how deep the field is. I think the whole game is elevated this year. I mean, we're seeing that because, you know, a guy like, say, Coop right now, you know, he just fully elevated, and now he's beating the guys that everybody kind of thought were unbeatable speed-wise, you know. Like, so it's, I mean, the whole game is different, you know. Even saw, I heard Jason was hurt early on, but you saw him struggle a little bit too right away with the new wave of guys. So I just think it has more to do with the competition than anything, you know. Like when I came in, I was pretty gung-ho early on. I've been pretty vocal about maybe how I peaked a little early before the series, and little bumps along the way, but I think it's all just little teeny pieces that I could do to improve myself, but it has more to do with how stacked it is. So if you're not completely perfect and not dialed, then you're just going to go that much further back. You know, it's not like you're just going to drop a position. You were a podium guy, and now you're a fifth place guy. It's like you could be a podium guy or a win guy if you're dialed, or a 12th place guy if you're not. You know, it's just a bigger number of guys that go by.
How hard is it to stay positive when things start going sideways?
I don't think it's that hard for me, because I'm a positive guy and I have a lot, you know, of things that I like about myself, and I'm fine with it. You know, I know that me staying positive is beneficial towards me getting better anyway, so I just lean on that a little bit. I lean on staying positive and just being me, not worrying about it. Because I don't think I'm better with pressure. I don't think I'm better with stress. I don't think I'm better, you know, none of that. Like, I don't think it actually improves me at all. So I lean on staying positive and just doing what I can do, and if it works, then good. But sometimes it takes longer to work than other times, you know. Sometimes you waste a whole year of your life trying to get better. But I think eventually it's going to come, and then when it does, everybody's going to be like, oh, there he is, you know, there's the 450 guy. So I just hope that comes, you know, soon.
Last question. You've been kind of at the center of a lot of people's ire. You know, a lot of people online have not hidden their thoughts on you. You've done a really good job not to even respond to it.
I haven't even heard.
You don't even care.
I don't even know.
Yeah.
Like, people have told me that, but like, I had one. I had one guy that I was like, that I responded to because, you know, they gave me a bunch of crap because I went and saw my buddy's show after Nashville when I hurt my back, and I, you know, they just saying like, oh, look at him, he's not hurt, he's just cruising around like no problem, like why doesn't he race? And it's like, that's not, that wasn't the point. Like, I was told to keep my back moving. Like, I was told not to just sit down. And so it's like, and I'm going and walking around, and you know, I met 30 different fans there, and they were stoked that I still came out, you know, hung out after a bad night. And it's like, so I keep a positive spirit through bad times, and it was almost like I was being crucified for that. I didn't think that was right. So I responded to the guy, I was like, I don't know, I said something just kind of like smart ass, like, this is like, oh wow, I'm so glad that you could tell I wasn't hurt, I should have called you instead of getting all that radiation and CT scans or stuff, you know what I mean, like just be a smart ass, because I didn't think it was cool. It's like, I went out, I was trying to still be cool and still keep my head up, and they're like, you know, put me up on this thing for that, and I was like, you know, whatever. But that's like the only thing I've ever even seen. I don't go looking for it, because 99.9999% of them have no idea what they're talking about, and as soon as you do good in one race, they're just like, oh, yeah, that's the guy. Like, it's so dumb. Like, I just can't get myself wrapped up in it at all. Like, it's not like I can't. Like, I could go on there and I could not care what I saw. I just don't. I literally don't even have like the time or the want to go look at who's him. It doesn't like enter this area at all.
Yeah. All right, we'll wrap it up on a positive. I'm glad you said all that. I'm glad to finally. I like giving you a platform to say it because I know everybody's just going to say bullshit, you know. And I know that you're not going to say a bunch, but you're just like, hey, look, here's enough. Here you go.
Nah, it just, to me, I'm just me, and if you don't like me for me, then I don't really, it doesn't matter if you do or not. Like, I'm pretty happy with who I am, and I know, you know, I know, and my camp, my people, my family, they all know what I go through. They all know how hard I work. You know, it's what people say that have no idea really doesn't bother me at all. Never has. You know, like, even when I was younger, before I ever did anything, you know, like, I remember people were giving me, like, you know, saying that I didn't deserve a ride or whatever. And saying that, you know, I had no shot. I was only getting it because of Josh or something like that. Like way back in, you know, like when I first got my ride, and I was like, I just won everything. Like as an amateur, like I just won, like I won championships at every single race. And then I got hurt, and I just had got my deal. It was just how it worked out. It was like, but I, you know, I won Monster Cup, I won Loretta's, like I won all the stuff that you would win to get a ride. So I looked at it, and I was just like, okay, why? I don't care. Like, why do you think that? So I was 17 when I realized that these opinions don't matter, I guess is my point. Like, it's not based on anything.
All right. Any music dropping soon? We'll wrap it up with that.
Yeah, soon. But, you know, that's the other thing. It's like, I've been, you know, people aren't paying attention to that either, because I've actually been putting that on the back burner because I'm trying to get better. So it's not like I'm, you know, I haven't been in the studio just grinding and doing that all the time. You know, I haven't wrote a song or really even played, and you know, since I, you know, way before Seattle, I just went up to Seattle to do that studio thing because it was a killer opportunity. A bunch of people got mad about that too. It's like, I haven't really been playing much.
But you have to have a release. You can't just have this. Everybody has something. If you work a 9-to-5 office job, you have a release. You get to have one too.
Well, if you work a 9-to-5 office job, your weekends, you go out and you party and you have a good time. Like, we don't really have the luxury of doing that all, like, very often because we're athletes. So it's not like that can be it, you know. So I've got a lot of things that I like to do outside of racing that I actually think benefit me. But, you know, sometimes I question it myself and I go, okay, am I doing too much of this? And then I start directing my focus more narrow, you know. And that was one of those, this has been one of those times where I haven't really been doing much of that. You know, I've just been trying to get better, so if I get better, it'll be worth it. If I don't,